My name is Michael Heisenbuttel from Platinum Group at Keller Williams, and today we're going to talk about why when people are talking about real estate, they always say cash is king. The process of buying and selling a house can be long and somewhat tricky, but today we're just going to focus on actually being under contract. If you're a buyer, that means you've already found the house and the seller has accepted your offer. And if you're a seller, that means you've gotten in your offers and you've accepted one of the buyer's offers and you're officially under contract. Step two, the loan approval, and step three, the appraisal, completely go away when you're paying cash. That's the main reason that people say cash is king. The other reason a lot of people like cash is because you're confident it's gonna close. You don't have a financing contingency, you're not worried about an appraisal, and you can close quicker. All three of those combine to say that cash is king. And to that same point, just because you're paying cash doesn't mean your offer is gonna get accepted. I mean, I see a lot of people, especially in this market, using the fact that they're paying cash to lowball sellers. At the end of the day, sellers in this market are getting multiple offers on every listing that's priced correctly. If you're coming in low with cash and somebody else is coming in over and with an appraisal gap on financing, they're gonna pick the higher price. You need to work with somebody that knows the market like the back of their hand and is gonna help you buy the house for the right price. Not lowballing so you never win an offer, but also not letting you overpay. Like we talked about in our last video, people are either moving because they want to move or because they have to move. And if you have to move, cash is more secure. I mean, you know that that person has that much money in their bank account that they don't have to worry about applying for a mortgage, going through the appraisal process, none of that. You know it's going to close. So what does that mean if you don't have cash? Should you just give up on buying altogether and rent for the rest of your life? Absolutely not. A good realtor is going to help you write a strong offer that can get accepted, sometimes even beating out on cash offers. I mean, just last week we had 9 offers on a listing and we didn't take the cash offer because it wasn't written as well as one with conventional financing. So what do you think? I would love to hear your thoughts. Is cash still king or does the best offer win? Let me know what you think down in the comments. If you've made it this far, consider subscribing and leaving me a like. I'd really appreciate it. In the meantime, I've been Michael and have yourself a great day.